In this video, I'm going to be talking about how you can use Trello in order for you to be an effective, efficient, and productive machine. And we're going to be using the Kanban process in order to do this. I've never known whether it was Kanban or Kanban. I prefer saying Kanban, but I think it's actually Kanban. Anyway, if you don't know who I am, my name is Michael Tabirade, coach and mentor, and I help self-starters and professional millennials in order to make sure that they increase their productivity, enhance their performance, and live their life on purpose. Now, if this is the first time checking out my YouTube videos, make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you can be notified of other videos like this. Now remember, all of the links for this video are in the description below. Now let's get to it. Kanban in Japanese means card you can see. And this was a process developed by Toyota back in the days when they were focusing on heavy manufacturing. And so understanding this, we can see that this process can streamline your projects, your programs, and things that you do day to day. Now I'm going to be sharing some insights in terms of how I use it for my business and personal life, but also how I utilize this in industry, in NHSX, when working on some of my processes as well. So make sure you hang tight and let's get to it. As I stated before, I'm going to be showing you how to use Trello in order for you to utilize the Kanban process or Kanban process to have more productivity and effectiveness as well. And as you can see, it says Trello helps teams work more collaboratively and get more done, but it's not just teams, it's also, you know, for yourself, for your personal life, and all the sort of things that you're trying to do as well. So again, if you haven't signed up to Trello already, go to their website here and you can actually log in. Now you can actually use Google, Microsoft, or continue with Apple, or you can use normal login if you want to. Again, I prefer to use some of these things, but you do whatever you're comfortable with. Now, because I've already got an account, I'm not gonna go through this process, but it's pretty much straightforward. Now, when you do actually sign up for an account, you'll be able to create a board, okay? And I'm gonna show you what one of those boards look like. Now, this is an example of a Kanban board that I have created. So this is a typical Kanban process. Now, again, you've got all of these different symbols here, and these effectively take me back to different boards. I can change the view based on something known as a butler that I have available to myself. So I can change it to calendar view or whatever it is. I can favorite this board if I need to. I can change the name here by just clicking on it, etc., etc. And I can invite people, which is really cool. Now, if we go through these different lists or columns, I call them, I'm going to go through them and explain each one in terms of how you can set this up. Now, just before we get into that, in order to create a list, this will pop up, especially if you have a blank canvas and you can click on it, type in the list. So I'm going to call it list example. And then you just click add list. And then underneath it, you can add a card. So test, I'm just going to call it that. And this is how you can create cards that you can move around. Okay, so I can move it there. I can move it here. If I click on this, then I can do all of this different stuff, which I'll get into a second. But I'm just gonna go to the left and go through each different board. So I've created these, through each different list, should I say. So I've created these different lists, and this one is how to use this board. So again, I've got some instructions here from Trello themselves if you want step-by-step advice and help with this. Underneath that, I've got an overview which explains each different list or board or column in more detail so you don't get confused. And I've also put in a Trello demonstration that should be able to help you as well. And I'll put this video as a demonstration as well. I've got a resources list, again, so different recommendations. So if we click on this, this will basically take you to, you know, different sort of books that I've read over the years, okay? Not all of them, but quite a lot of them. So you can check that out for yourself if you're interested. But this is about Kanban and Trello. So again, this is also another sort of like thing you can check out in order for you to improve your productivity. So definitely check that out once you get the chance. And the last thing is if you're looking to get some weekly motivation, then definitely check out this link here. So here I've got different objectives, okay? And these objectives are based on the Wheel of Life. So I think there are 9 here. And the reason I've put them here is because these are typical different areas that we have in our life that we focus on. So we've got health, learning and personal growth, career, business, money, home, environment, significant other, and relationships. Now this will stay here, it won't go anywhere else. Now this is the main sort of like bit of the Kanban process. You've got backlog, you've got to do, and you've got doing, okay? Now, again, these are very important because backlog is essentially all the different things that you can think of in terms of the actions that you need to take for health, for career, for money, for X, Y, and Z. So that's the first thing. The second thing is the to-do. So that's effectively your action log or your things to do for the next 2 weeks. So you can see this is a 2 week time period and it creates the right level of pressure in order for you to move. So those of you familiar with the agile process within the corporate world would understand this, okay? So again, I would list everything that is, you know, needs to be done within the next 2 weeks. And anything that I'm doing right now within those 2 weeks, I would put in here. So I'm very clear about what's happening. So again, let's explore a board even more. So this is something that, you know, I was using as an example for YouTube. So let's do a completely different one. So we already know how to use the description thing. Maybe I've got a deadline. It needs to be done within the next 2 weeks. So again, if I go to, let's leave the members for now. If I go to due date, then maybe I think I can get it done by the 17th and I wanna do it by 6 o'clock, okay, in the afternoon. So if I save this, I can also set a reminder, let's say 10 minutes before, and I save it. Now, it will send you notifications to your phone and or to your email, depending on what email you signed up with, and that's the best way in order for you to get notified, okay? So that's one way of doing it. Now, again, you can add members as well. It's only me, so there's not really a point if it's just for yourself. If you don't think it fits in with one of those life areas or a label, as Trello calls it, then you can change it. You can have multiple different ones on there if you believe it links, okay? I'm just gonna leave it as is. You can also attach things. So you can link it to your Google Drive, to your Dropbox, and to your OneDrive, or you can attach a website. So for example, I can do my website, okay? Which makes sense. And if you're seeing all this random stuff pop up like dots and everything else, it's because my keyboard is acting a bit annoying. So I'm gonna do Michael, and then you click attach. And it processes and it pops up, okay? So really, really neat stuff. You can also add covers, okay? So you can get covers from Unsplash. So for those of you who don't know what Unsplash is, this is a free photo stock website. So I like this one. Or you can actually choose a different color. So let's choose this color. Maybe it links to the sort of theme that I want to, you know, use for my life area. So I want it to be a bit more inspiring. So let's click on this and that's that. I'm just gonna leave it like this. And if I close that, then again, this pops up as a cover and this is the first thing that I can see, okay? So when I move it, it moves with the card, okay? And again, once you've completed something, you move it into done. And that's that, it's out of the way. So every single day, I focus on this Trello board and I look at what I need to do. And then if there's nothing in here, as an example, then I can move it from to do into doing. And once the 2 weeks is done, then again, I just need to change the date. Okay, I just changed the date here. So I do that all the time on a two or bi-weekly basis. I've got BAU here, which is business as usual. So these may be tasks that you do on a weekly, monthly, or annual basis, on a regular basis. So you may want to add that stuff. That may be stuff like, I don't know, let's say for example, content distribution specifically, or it could be stuff around exercise, etc., etc. If you're working as part of a project, you may want to add blockers or dependencies that are preventing you from doing specific things. So these are risks, things that haven't happened but potentially could happen that could have an impact on your actual project or program that you're working on. And again, I also have this area here where you may want to add ideas. Now, you don't necessarily have to add this because, again, you can add the ideas to the actual card if you want. You can also, again, if this is a personal board, add the ideas to a specific objective down here. It's totally up to you. Again, what I haven't highlighted is that you're able to actually add a checklist. So you can see that here, there's a checklist. Very simple to sort of add. So you can add checklists here. This is a test checklist as an example. And you can also get checklists from other cards if you wanted to. And if you click add, you can add items. So item one, enter, item two, enter, etc., etc. And again, depending on what sort of, like, you know, package you have with Trello, you can do more advanced stuff as well. And once I tick it off, it shows and it represents my progress as well. So really, really useful stuff, really, really good stuff. Now, let's say, for example, you know, you want to keep an eye on this stuff. This is what the watch card does. So every time something happens to this board, if you click on watch, you should get a notification on email related to this specific card if you want to, okay? You can also share this with the right sort of person, okay, this specific card. And in addition, if you don't want this card anymore, you can put it into archive, okay? So you click that, and if you want to delete it, you click on delete, but I'm not going to delete it. So a few more things. If I go to show menu, again, it shows you some stuff. So let me just go to the main menu. So this is the main menu, okay? You can change the background if you want to different stuff. So you've got different colors, you've got different photos, so you can change it to any of this stuff, okay? If I go back again, if I go to more, I can also do a thing where I can actually, again, share this board with anybody who wants to actually check out this board as well. So you can create public links. And if you want to change it to private, as an example, you can click here and turn it into private, okay? So here's a few things that you can check out. You can also check out archived items. So this I archived before. So again, I can send it back to the board if I want to, and it pops up back there as well, okay? You can also do a thing where you can actually change the labels here instead of doing it within the card. So that's another way of doing it yourself, okay? And here's a neat little trick. On the desktop, if I click on the label, it shows you the actual label name. If I click on it again, it disappears. That's one thing that you can do. Another thing that you can do is you can actually show what sort of labels or cards that you want to show. So let's say, for example, if I type in content, enter, it will show everything that's got content with it, but that's for everything within Trello, okay, as an example. Another thing that you can do is you can stop watching certain cards if you want to. And if I go back to show menu, I can actually only show cards, okay, if I go to search cards that have certain labels or due a certain week, okay? So if I say due next week, there's no cards due next week. If I show cards, let me take this off, that have health with it, again, it will show me only the cards with health with it, okay? So really, really useful for doing quick stuff, okay? And you can also do it with members as well. So that's pretty much it. That's how you use Trello, but more specifically, the Kanban process in order for you to be effective. Now, again, you don't have to use Trello. You can use Asana. You can use many other sort of productivity tools in order for you to be effective as well. So go ahead, try it for yourself. Try it for your productivity tool. And again, stick to this on a daily basis. And I promise you, it will really make a difference to what you're doing, not just only in your personal life, but again, if you're part of a team or if you have a program or project that you're working towards, this is really, really useful. So hopefully you enjoyed this session. Bonus time. That was so lame, but whatever. I have to do this for the YouTube and that. So if you want to make sure that you're effective with the Kanban process and Trello, then what you want to do is invite someone to your personal board. Because if you do that, you get to a point of accountability. You get to a point of making sure that you do the things that you said you were going to do long after the feeling was gone. And so if someone is actually monitoring your process, actually really getting notifications every time you make a change, you know you're actually going to get stuff done. And this is how you can leverage your productivity to a point where you're actually achieving specific results, or at least failing forward. That reminds me, the next video is going to be based on accountability partners and how you can use them effectively. So make sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell. And as always, understand, reach, and expand. Peace.